I did a screencast a long time ago about Syscalls, but I don't remember what I did. So I'll do another one. Maybe it's the same information, maybe not. There's a basic Hello World program. It only prints Hello World. So let's compile it. Would you see? Ah, I can just use the normal. Just see. What does it link against? It links against libc. These other two are just special to Linux. It has to do with loading dynamic libraries, but the only dynamic library really loaded is this libc. So obdump dumps to disassembly. So here we can see the entry point for the program is underscore start, so it always starts at start. So you might not know, but when you write a program, you think the entry point is main, but it's not, because the compiler adds an underscore start function that does some stuff, mainly copies arguments and the environment variables. So if I run, just print that, and if I put some arguments here, then these are copied to the program so it can access it if we had wanted. But we didn't, because we put void here. But if we did not put void up here, we could have accessed the arguments from the command line. So now most of what is happening in this underscore start function is actually unnecessary. The only thing the start really has to do is call main and then exit. So what it instead does is calls a function from libc called libc.start_main, and this is the function that actually initializes all this stuff and then jumps to main. And let's see, then we have main, and main loads some address into RDI, and RDI is the first register where you put the first argument on x86-64 architecture, and then calls puts. So that was a little bit strange, because here we had printf, but puts, it puts a string that and adds a new line. So it seems the compiler understood, because we have a string that ends with a new line and no arguments, printf is unnecessarily complicated. It can be simplified with just the puts and hello world. So let's see what strings are in the hello binary. Should we see hello world somewhere here without new line? So here it is, hello world. And there's a lot of stuff here which are not really necessary. We have a comment section, we have a note section, and so on. Could actually. Here it is. If you run this line, you can actually remove the comment section and the note section. So, with the hello binary and out. So the hello is 8312 bytes, and hello no comments, 8176 bytes. We stripped two sections away. And it still works. So you see, D disassembles all sections. So now it's maybe hard to see, but there is no comment section anymore. And we could remove more sections. I don't know. Because this program is so simple, you could probably remove more sections. Yeah. So let's debug. Hello. And I have this PIDA extension to GDB, which makes it easier to debug binary functions. let's see, it jumps straight to main, where it loads something to register RDI. What could that be? Well, RDI here, it's blah 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 blah. And Peda is so smart, it says, guesses that this is probably a point to a string. And here we have hello world without a new line. And then we are here, and the next thing is going to call puts, or the trampoline to puts, which jumps into libc. So it removed the new line and then called puts instead of printf. And here we can also see guest arguments. Hello world. And call puts. And now we can't really see the output because for a very brief moment the output was there, but then it was overwritten again. And as I explained, we jumped from underscore start into libc start main. And then from libc start main to main. So ret here should return into libc start main. So let's see if that is the case. Where is the stack? This is the first pointer on the stack that's going to jump to when you call ret. And it's indeed inside libc start main. So if I step here, so we should jump into libc. Now we are inside the libc library. And the previous instruction, call rax, is where we jumped into main. And after main finished, we returned into this libc start main. And this cleans up and calls exit. What is in EAX? It did exit with code 016. Maybe E is 016 octal. Now I'm actually guessing very low. Yes, it's octal, 16. It exits with code E. Why? Why, I wonder? Yes, it did. 14, that was the... was that the length of the Hello World string now? That's shorter. Where is it? 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Well, that is actually the length. Maybe that just happened to be there, because I put void as an exit for main and not int. Let's try to change the int to see if the return code is 0 instead. Yeah, now the return code is 0. What now the machine code looks. So there was the call to puts, and now 0. Yes, 0 is moved to EAX. Base pointer is restored, and then return into libc. Okay, so everything's the same except before returning from main. It moved 0 into register AX, and that 0 also came into here. But what register holds the what register holds the syscall number? Let's follow this a little bit more. Oh, this goes very deep. Everything you see here happens when you just do a simple syscall. And just totally unnecessary because... now I stepped over it. It was this one that had the interesting code. Yeah. Now it exited normally. We didn't even print the ret code. Anyway. can check the manual page for Syscall. So here, I don't think you have to say that it has GNU extensions, because I tried without, and you just have to include UNISTD and Syscall. I can just copy this. Oh, so nice. Main void. Syscall. And the first argument is the number, Syscall number. And this syswrite is defined in sys/syscall.h. We could also check, I think it's in user include us. Right. Yeah, it's one. The syscall number for right is one. So I could write the one here instead of this sys_write. And the second argument is the string. Hello world. Now I have to put... And then the length. I don't know how long it was. 40, it was 14, so I put 14 bytes here. It should print hello world, but it didn't. That was a little bit strange. Yeah, because I have to also put in the standard out file pointer. It's not a file pointer, just a file descriptor. So the descriptor of standard out is 1. Okay, now it works. So here, and then comes the argument. So we could just look at in section 2 of the manual pages are the syscalls. So this is actually the syscall write that we called. And in the first is the file descriptor, and then the string, and then the length of the string to write. And now a caveat is that the write might not return count characters. It only returns how many it managed to write. So if this write was interrupted by an interrupt, perhaps, maybe it only took 5 characters out. So you should really, in a real program, check how many bytes write actually wrote. And if not all bytes were written, then call write again with the rest of the bytes in the buffers. So put this in some kind of loop that loops until the whole buffer has been printed. So that's basically what puts and printf does, but they do even more complicated stuff like buffered output. So they wait until they have a whole buffer full, and then they write the whole buffer at the same time. Okay. To minimize this, I would like to know how does the assembly code for a syscall look. Now I can insert some more code here. So let's say I put a function called scall. That does a syscall. So this is actually very unrealistic, but I just want to look at the assembly code for the generated scall function. The semicolon should be here. It's a little hard to see with this old school font. Okay, now that worked, but let's see the scall assembly. Well, it probably just jumps to the trampoline, but I want to see it. Here. So we want to do something similar. And I did that already. It's here. We edit the make file. Yeah, that's the 64-bit version. Yeah, okay. I jump a little bit to conclusions. But remember, the start. The only thing underscore start did, it was call main and then call exit. So we don't even need to link against libc at all. We could just define our own underscore start function that calls main and calls exit. But to do this, the syscall function is also in libc. So what we have to do is write our own scall function that does a syscall. Take the put syscall number as input and then the arguments after that. So this is, it turns out, not so hard. Just look at what I did exactly as before, but I did a static linking and then checked the assembly output like this. So this was generated code, and even this is not. This is, you could even remove this CFI start proc and CFAI end proc here. So we could make it even shorter. But what it does, because it's in the RAX. No, it's in RDI, the first argument, but the Linux kernel want it in RAX. This is called number, and then it was the first argument in RDI. So we have to shift around all this. So our function can take at most this is called number, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 arguments. So if you need more than 5 arguments, you're in trouble. You can't use this function as called. So let's look at the make file again. So I put a lot, I spent a while googling and checking the manual page for GCC, and this removes some sections. But I did not put this, I could remove more, I could remove the comment section too with this obj dump thing. Where is that? Do I have that? No, it must be in this profile. Yeah. After building the binary, here, good, ob copy. This is the input, and then we just have some temporary output. And let's move the temporary output to input. So this line removes the comment section and the notes section. And we can just hope that there's no file called timpout in our directory here. Yeah, so here's the start. And if your start function in that file here is the scall function, and here's our main syscall. You can check how it looks. So it just calls scall syswrite hello world. And scall.h, it tells how scall, what it takes for arguments. It just has one mandatory argument, the syscall number, and then number of optional arguments, which we looked in the source code, could not be more than 5, but we didn't specify that here. Ah. TMP. Okay. Okay, now syscall is statically linked. And it's not very large, but we could still strip it to make it smaller. And it became smaller. But it's still almost 5k. And we can run it. It prints hello world, and we can debug it. Look at it with Objdump. Objdump all sections. Now we see. We could probably remove more sections here too. I don't know if there's anything valuable in read-only data. Or maybe, yeah, maybe it's the hello world string is in there. But it's pretty much smaller than before. This is not very big. Alright, and GDB. Now GDB doesn't really know where we are. Yes, in main. Wonder if it can see start. Hello world. If I break at start, break underscore start, yeah, it worked, and I just run. So now we are at start, and look, start, here is the start, beginning of start. It just does one thing, push RAX, and then calls main. It's extremely short. Call main, and now it's in main, and main doesn't do very much. It pushes the argument. Now this code is it can't really guess what's happening. Is this even correct? Syscall 1. Yeah, and DX as the string. Is that correct? Should it be in DX? Ah, let's see if but it worked. And now we're in the syscall function. And now we are just before we jump into the Linux kernel. Here is the jump into the Linux kernel. And here we can see that RAX has the syscall number. DI has the file pointer. SI has the string. DX has the length. Yeah, and that's all the arguments that are used by the syscall. And if we just continue from here, it should still print. Yeah, and it did. Hello world. Because it's this line that jumps in the kernel and actually prints hello world. And then, okay, I didn't show it. Maybe run again. Let's see what happens when main. Okay, wait, here's the syscall. Just jump over that. Now we're back in underscore start. Here we jumped into main. And now we're back in underscore start. So this should call exit. So let's see if it did that. It put 3C hex into exit and zero. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so I think 3C is, we can check. Sixty. So let's see with the calculator. Decimal 60, what's in hex? It's 3C hex, yes. So that 3C hex or 60 decimal is the syscall number for exit. So next, exit should just exit. We shouldn't be in next. Now the program should exit if I just put next here. Yes or no? Now we jumped into the S call. We haven't exited until we come to the syscall line. Okay, now this line. Exit program. Boom. Okay, this was a bit unstructured, but I hope you understood something.